Well, hello. Now, you might be wondering what I have here. And quite obviously, this is Play-Doh. And it's not my Play-Doh, or at least that's what I tell the public. It's my son's Play-Doh, two little boys. So Play-Doh's like king, number one. Right. So I had to ask this morning if I could bring or borrow my son's Play-Doh to come and teach you a lesson, right? And the deal was that I only was allowed to take one tub, all right, as long as I brought it back, right? So I did that, but then I also took another tub as well, just in case, all right? And some of the tools as well, which I'll show you here in a second. Now, why have I done something like this? Why am I sitting behind two little people who are Play-Doh? Well, what I want to do is introduce you to two types of coaches, okay? Now, this coach here, he is called Stressed Out Steve, okay? Stressed Out Steve. But this coach here, this is Chilled Out Kathy. Stressed Out Steve, Chilled Out Kathy. And so, all right, why would I create two wonderful Play-Doh figures like this? You can see that in art, in school, I must have really excelled, right? Well, it's to prove a point. I want to tell you a little story. Let's talk about Stressed Out Steve, okay, who's a coach. And it doesn't matter what kind of coach he is, doesn't matter what industry he's in, just all that matters is that he's a coach. He coaches people in some sort of topic. It could be personal fitness, it could be relationship, it could be a life coach, it could be a business coach. It could be so many other types of coaches. The type of coach is not important, it's the fact that he's a coach. Stressed Out Steve is a coach. Now, Chilled Out Kathy, she's exactly the same coach. In fact, they have the exact same amount of experience, same qualifications, same attitude. They are virtually identical. Stressed out Steve, Chilled Out Kathy. Except for one difference. So let's talk about Stressed Out Steve. Now Steve runs his coaching business, and some months it's really busy. He's got clients all over the place. Steve, get me this, Steve, get me that, help me here, help me there. And other months, no one's there. Then other months, they're all back again. Do you like these guys? These are good, right? And these don't represent real clients, of course. So some months busy, some months totally flat. So no consistency of income. Really annoying for Stressed Out Steve because he has to manage his cash flow. He still has bills that come in every month, but he doesn't have clients that come in every month. That's a bit of an issue. And so he's madly trying to look after his clients that are there because they've paid for attention. So he gives them attention and he's always wondering, you know, how can I make sure I keep them happy? Of course, to get these clients on board, what he did was he discounted his price just to get them on board. And what that made them think is that he actually wasn't worth what he was originally charging. And so they don't give him the respect that he deserves, okay? So they're always trying to squeeze him for more, always trying to squeeze Steve for more. All right, and he happily, all right, I'll do that for you, because he needs these folks as clients, otherwise they'll leave and he's out of business. So that's how he's stressing out about just keeping them happy. He does a lot of one-on-one. In fact, it's all one-on-one. And so therefore, he needs to go and see them in their offices, but he also has a lot of repetitive tasks. So he'll explain the same information to one client as he does to the rest of the clients as well. So it's a bit of repetitive stuff, not for them, but for him, right? So for them, they're getting great personal attention. For him, it's like he's repeating himself a lot and he's having to spend a lot of client time, right? And the problem with that is, if we bring back our clients, there's only so many of these clients that he can handle. All right, so maybe 10, maybe 20, and he's maxed out. He struggles to get to that, but if he did, he's limited to the amount of income that he can earn, right? So he spends a lot of his time when he hasn't got clients. Wait till you see this prop. He spends a lot of his time giving proposals out, right? See that? Drops them off at his prospects, and you can see the real proposals because they have words on them, written words, right? So that's what they represent. So he sends out the proposals and he waits for the clients to get back or prospects to get back with him where they will want to negotiate and work out a deal with Steve, again, probably lowering his price so he can get them on board. So he's always doing proposals, handing them out, following up, seeing if everything's okay, do you understand this, do you understand that, can I help you, blah, blah, blah. So he spends a lot of time doing that. Now, he's also been listening to a lot of gurus and they say you've got to have lots of traffic sorts of traffic sources. Do you like that tie-in? Traffic, beep, beep, right? Lots of traffic sources, which means, you know, some SEO, search engine optimization. It means social media marketing. It means article marketing, video marketing, SMS marketing, email marketing. And meanwhile, stressed out Steve, you can just see his hair starting to stand up on end. He's going crazy over here going, his head's about to burst, because he's got to not only manage his business, but he's now got to become a traffic expert as well. And so he dabbles here and dabbles there, but none of them really quite work that well. And also a lot of these gurus that he listens to says you've got to have a sales funnel, which means you've got to have a whole process of where you might give away a product for free, then a second one at 47, then a third one at 97, then at 197, then at 297, then at 397, then at 997. A whole process, a whole string. It's called the Ascension Model. So he's now got to create about 3 to 4 or 5 different levels of product and support them all. That takes months to do. And these funnels, which sound so intelligent, of which they are, but when you go to run them, they're too intelligent, they're confusing as hell. And so now he's getting more and more stressed out. His hair is standing like, he's probably losing his hair, but his brain is fried. Trying to do all that, right? And so what it does, it actually keeps him up at night. It keeps him up at night, right? So he's stressed out with his family. That he doesn't want to go home stressed, but it's starting to, you know, eat over into his family life. He's got children he needs to play with and look after, take to school, take to soccer. He's got a wife to support, even just emotionally, and then there's also financially, and then there's things like that. So this is all on top of Steve, right? While he's got this going on at work. And it's making him sick, like bleh, sick. And so there's Steve being sick all over himself. That's terrible, right? It's terrible. So, poor Steve's not in a good way. Stressed out Steve is there for a reason, right? He's that in that state for a reason. And what it's doing is not helping him at all, right? It's a stress. He'd almost be better going and getting a job, right? What about chilled out Kathy over here? Well, what's her deal? Because let me tell you about chilled out Kathy. Chilled out Kathy can have as many clients as she wants, literally hundreds, and she still only has to work around about 10 hours a week. Yeah, 10 hours a week. Wouldn't that be cool, right? That's what chilled out Kathy does. Stressed out Steve would love to be able to think he could actually do that, but he's doing about 80 hours a week at least, all right? Even when he's not busy, he's still stressing out and working to get more traffic and to find out what's going wrong in his business. Whereas chilled out Kathy, she has around about 5 clients apply to become her client, 5 prospects rather become her client every single week. It's consistent flow of prospects coming into Kathy's business who apply to work with her. So she chooses the clients that she wants to work with. She doesn't have to negotiate, doesn't have to lower her prices, and she doesn't have to choose anyone she doesn't want to work with, because sometimes there's good clients and sometimes there's bad clients, right? So this is right. So in the end, the clients that she chooses, they love Kathy. They love her because she lets the one in have the best energy, that are going to do everything she asks them to do. She doesn't have to hound them, doesn't have to constantly check in to see where they are. They do all the work that she knows they need to do and tells them to do. They love her and she loves them. So it's a great relationship, right? That's the great part. And of course, her lifestyle, at working only 10 hours a week, even though she has hundreds of clients, well, that allows a lot of time for ice cream and cocktails. That probably is for ice cream as well in the Play-Doh world, but not in my world. That's for cocktails. That symbolizes cocktails. And it also allows her to fly. Allows her to travel, not in a UFO, but that there wasn't any plane tools in the kit. So anyway, like she's able to fly, travel anywhere she wants, and her business still runs. So that she actually does group training, right? So she doesn't do one-to-one, she does group training. That's the exciting thing. So she can actually attend all of her clients. She talks to them once a week in a Q&A session. She has a private little Facebook group, and then her online training is all done on drip feed. So no matter when someone comes into Kathy's business, they start at module 1, work through to module 8, week by week by week, and she's just monitoring. She isn't hassling them, but she's just monitoring that they're actually, the system's working beautifully. But they diligently go and do the work. They diligently go and do the work. And so what happens is she's got a beautiful business. Stressed out Steve, chilled out Kathy. Beautiful business model. She's able to have the time she wants. She's able to have clients on demand. She's able to have freedom. But she's also able to impact her clients the same way as Steve when he works one-on-one. Still impacts them, still makes a difference in their lives. So you've got to ask, what is chilled out Kathy doing that stressed out Steve isn't? What is she doing, right? And she has a formula, a way, a model of running her business, which makes a massive difference. A model. Different model is the only difference between chilled out Kathy, stressed out Steve. Otherwise, they're exactly the same. But she has a different model of running her business, and it makes all the difference. So that she has the lifestyle she wants, has the income she wants. She's charging clients between $3,000 and $10,000 a time to be part of her coaching program. All right, so she has 100 clients, that's 300,000. She has 200 clients, that's 600,000. She can easily hit $1 million a year without it actually taking more of her time. Okay, so this is a massive difference. Poor Steve, who's still vomiting all over himself, it's killing him. Look, it's hurting him right in the heart. Let me just do this. It's killing him, right? He's falling over as we speak. And so he's getting cut down to size by his clients. They're chewing him out. His partner, his wife's chewing him out. He's getting cut down, and all his hopes are crushed. Now, that's a bit graphic with stressed out Steve. I get it. But do you understand the point? It's all about the model. Coaches, two of them exactly the same, except this one here has a different model, and it makes all the difference. Now, if you love my little silly Play-Doh experiment here, my Play-Doh lesson, then you might want to join me on a special class I'm running called Coachification. It's how to have a business like chilled out Kathy, not stressed out Steve, all right? And in that class, it goes for about 45 minutes. I will teach you three things of how to actually make that happen. It's a real class, and there's nothing to buy on the class. Trust me, nothing to buy. It's full content. If that interests you, then you'll find a link below this wonderful video, and I'll be able to teach you and give you some really good stuff on how you can actually go away and do it right away. Would that be good? So if you're a coach, a consultant, or you really want to be one, then this is the place to start. You want to have a business like this, all right? So go ahead, register right now, and I'll teach you coachification, all right? I'll see you there.